Well, here we are. Remember that Ford 9600 my boy got here a while back? I guess it's a matter of will it ever run again. He had it running, and then he decided to change some things a little bit. I'll show you what he decided to change. Some reason or another, that engine right there, I don't know, decided not to use it. A bunch of pieces and a bunch of pieces. Now we got this great big thing here. Put a bright light on something and see what it is. Still can't see. What is it?
This is a tag right there.
Yeah. It's got a tag on it. It's a Ford engine of some sort. What'd you say it was? A Genesis or something? Mm-hmm. 175 horse. I know. Anyhow, that's what we're up to today. I'll try to make it run. Well, I take a picture with the lights turned on. We'll see whether we can see it any better. Nearabouts. All right.
Pretty close on that. Might need to bust a 8-inch or something. Does it need to bust this? Yeah, about 8-inch or so here today. See? Huh? Wouldn't be very safe to support it on a jack, would it?
Thank you. Put your...
Thank you.
anybody else have any plans? All right, we gotta take it apart again, we'll shut the camera off. All right, is it on there now?
Top team bolts are on.
There, you got a couple over here, you tighten up now.
Top team bolts are on, that's cool.
You put lock washers on this big bolt?
No, is that?
Huh?
Is that part of it or not?
Well, here, come over, tighten these two up. And we won't fall off. I'm going to tighten these other two here. How come you're using tin oil pan instead of a cast iron oil pan? Yeah, but don't that help support the tractor and the feet in the middle? Huh? Why?
Got the hard part done now, huh? Well, you can make it a two-wheel drive or something other. That's on there. I guess it's quitting time now for me. All right. Let's say thank you.
Yep.
Okay.